Assalamu alaikum, namaste, and welcome everybody to the News Hour with your favorite host and dost Jennifer Rogers. And if you are new to our channel, do not forget to share this video with all your friends and family so they are aware about all the things happening in Qatar and all around the world. And with that, we are also available on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter, where we post a lot of interesting content and it's just for you. And if you haven't subscribed to our YouTube channel yet, please go ahead and do so. Subscribe to our YouTube channel. It is also called Qatar Day. And do not forget to check out our other channel, which is called QatarDay.com. And with this, I have two local news for you and one international. So let's just get into it. Now, first, let us discuss about the Vande Bharat mission and the list of all the repatriated flights from Qatar to India in the phase 7 for the October list of 2020. Now, the Ministry of External Affairs in India has published the complete schedule of the repatriation flights under the Vande Bharat mission phase 7 of October 2020. Now, the list is quite big, so I'm not going to really discuss the entire list with you guys. I'm going to put it down in the comment section so you can read it out for yourself. But I am quickly going to just read out a small note that has been given by the Ministry of External Affairs in India. This is a dynamic list and it is bound to undergo, they say, changes based on operational, technical and other considerations. Now, this list should not be considered as a final one and this will only be for the purpose of information. This list cannot be quoted for any legal claims and all the visitors are advised to counter-check with Air India for the confirmation of the flight, the timings, day, destination and the other details. Now, let's talk about the other local news of today, which is Qatar has now released the updates of low risk countries. So the list is out, the updated list of all the low risk countries is out there, and I'm just going to give you a little information about that. I know a lot of people ask me about it, so we're going to discuss that today. Now, as Qatar continues to implement these travel policies, the list of low risk countries have been updated based on the public health indicator in Qatar and around the world, and they have been announced right now. Now, the changes came directly on effect from October 1st, the MOP had said on its website. Now, the list is updated and the list includes 47 low-risk countries, which are Europe first. From Europe, they have Hungary, Finland, Norway, Italy, Greece, and a lot of other lists. If you want, I can put down this entire list for you guys in the comment section so it's easier for you guys to read. Now, after this, they have started to Asia as well. It's Thailand, China, Vietnam, Malaysia, South Korea, Japan, Turkey, Singapore and Taiwan. Now, America, it's Cuba, Canada and Mexico. Africa is Algeria and Morocco. And Oceania, it's New Zealand and Australia. Now, while Singapore, Taiwan, Russia, Bulgaria, Malta, Romania and Mexico have been added to the list of the low-risk countries, the Czech Republic, which will include on the previous list, has been removed. So, Czech Republic has now been removed. It was earlier, but now it's not there. Now, the list is subject to change at the discretion of the MOPH. One can visit the ministry's website for the updates. Now, let's get to the international news of the day, which is Trump is taken to hospital after being tested positive. So I hope you guys know, and if you don't, I'm here to give you the information that now Trump and his wife is also tested positive for coronavirus. So a feverish US President Donald Trump has been flown to the hospital after testing positive for coronavirus. The White House said that the president was fatigued but in good spirits and was taken to hospital as a precaution. Now, Trump received an experimental drug cocktail injection at the White House after he and the First Lady Trump both tested positive for coronavirus. Now, both the Trumps, both his wife and him, were tested positive. Okay. Now, it is a potential setback as he trails Democratic challenger Joe Biden at a month before the presidential elections. Now, you know, as the presidential elections for US is going to start, and this is such a setback for Donald Trump right now. And how did the president look on Friday? What was his look on Friday? How did he look? Was he fine? Was he not fine? So let's talk about that. Now, wearing a mask and a suit, Mr. Trump walked out across the White House lawn on Friday afternoon to his helicopter, Marine One, for the short flight to the Walter Reed National Military Medical Center in the Washington, D.C. suburbs. He waved and gave a thumbs up to the reporters but said nothing before boarding the aircraft. In a video posted on Twitter, Mr. Donald Trump said that, I think I'm doing very well, he said, but we're going to make sure that things work out. The First Lady is doing well as well, so thank you very much. Now, this is what he said. And with this, I'm done with all the updates for today. Thank you so much for logging on to Qatar Day. Keep loving, keep supporting as you always do, as you always support me. Thank you so much, and I appreciate each and everyone. I hope you guys had a very, very happy weekend, and I'll see you guys tomorrow, same time, same place. Until then, remember to look after yourself. It's very, very important. You stay healthy and you stay safe, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Until then, Khuda Hafiz.